It's always the edibles. That's about all I can remember hearing the emergency room nurse say to one of her coworkers as I lay there, catatonic. Now, let me back up and give you a little context to this day that ended quite differently than I expected. So I had a very good friend that was getting married. Beautiful day last spring. Got married at an outdoor wedding in Westchester, Pennsylvania, and had the reception at a very nice restaurant in Philadelphia, which is about an hour drive away. So he had hired a luxury coach to transport people back and forth. And of course, the party starts on the bus. The champagne's flowing, there's Hennessy, and my friend, the groom, comes around and offers me a gummy, a pot gummy. Well, at first I decline, until cousin Rhonda starts goading me. Well, I had one, and I don't even get high. Well, I just met cousin Rhonda that day, but I was not gonna be gummy Shane, so give me that thing. I eat half of it. Now I'm sitting there with half a gummy in my hand and thinking, what am I gonna do with the other half? Put it in my pocket, my nice suit? Just eat the other half. And I figured, I'm always the responsible one. I'm always the designated driver. You wanna go out, we'll drink, we'll party, I'll drive, no problem. And we've got a bus transporting us back and forth and a few hours in between. What could go wrong? Also, I'm no stranger to cannabis. So I've had pot brownies before. And the thing with edibles is it's the same kind of slow burn. So it takes a couple of hours before that curtain starts to descend over you and you're really stoned. Well, that moment hit right as the reception is starting. And I could feel where this was going, so I went in the bathroom and I'm splashing water on my face and I'm going outside and I'm trying to get some air, and I just had to go back in, except now the space just felt smaller, the ceiling felt lower, people felt closer. And as the best man is giving his very heartfelt toast to his best friend, I'm sitting there having an internal dialogue. Don't pass out. Hold it together. Don't pass out. And then I passed out. So from here, the narrator gets details filled in by others. Apparently, my head was slumped right down on my chest. And someone yells, call 911. Because it's perfectly reasonable to think that the white-haired man with the white beard might have just had a stroke or a heart attack and needs some help. So they lay me out on the floor, loosen my tie, unbutton my collar, and there I could hear voices talking to me, but I was really quite comfortable. And I open my eyes, and it's just like you see on TV, where there are heads floating over you, and people talking. They're like, do you have any pain? No. Is there any tightness in your chest? No. Well, then the EMTs come, and they sit me up in a chair, and the EMTs say, sir, can you slide over onto the transport chair? No. No, I can't. So they scooch me over, strap me in, and I close my eyes, and the next few minutes are like some stoned amusement park ride of me being taken out of the restaurant, down hallways and up elevators, and I get outside on the street and I can feel the breeze, and oh, I hear the city noises, and then they bump me up into the ambulance and put me on the stretcher. And the first thing the people in the ambulance have me do in my condition is to sign an iPad allowing them to transport me. Which, in all honesty, is the same signature I give at the grocery store with my finger. But then they give me two choices of hospitals. Would you rather go here or here? Number two, I don't know. So I was able to pull it together and tell them I had an edible. Well, they put away the paddles, they just sat back. They're good for the ride. All I remember from that ride is that I was laying there with my eyes closed, and at some point I said to no one in particular, I grew up in the 70s, and I've been stoned before, but what the fuck? So when you get to the emergency room, the only thing they can do for you in this condition is to hydrate you, and you have to ride it out, which I did for the next 5 hours. Somewhere after midnight, I was finally able to walk on my own, caught an Uber to take me the 35 miles to my house. But the irony to the whole story is that this day that I decided to shed adult responsibilities, just go for it, and end up stoned off my ass in the emergency room was April of 2019, to be exact, Saturday, 4:20.